Been thinking a lot about toilet paper recently. And wondering, where did ancient people go to the bathroom? To understand where people used to go to the bathroom, we first have to define bathrooms, which isn't exactly easy. If we mean the place where defecation occurs, then for much of modern history, well into the 19th century, that was the bedroom. People would often keep their chamber pots, which are just big old poop bowls, right underneath their beds. I'm not sure what's scarier, the boogeyman or your earthly shame lying right underneath you as you sleep. If by bathroom we mean the place where toilets are, then that really depends where you are in space and time. Perhaps the first toilets were in the cities of the Indus Valley civilization from some 4,500 years ago. The houses of Mohenjo-Daro in central Pakistan bear a remarkable resemblance to our modern bathrooms. Many houses included private rooms containing a bath and an elevated latrine that dumped waste into the communal sewage system. But the privacy that we and the residents of Mohenjo-Daro enjoy wasn't always universal. In ancient Rome, hygiene was a public affair, and in addition to their many baths, they built public toilets that all faced each other. Side note, is this why they conquered the Mediterranean? It takes steely determination to look another man in the eye when you poop. And if I'm Carthage in that situation, I'm like, I'm out. Anyway, between toilets and chamber pots, there's a lot of variation in how people went to the bathroom in the past. But if you didn't have those things, where would you go? It appears that for the vast amount of human history, our ancestors practiced open defecation, which means pooping outdoors. We don't have a whole lot of direct evidence for this, but we do know that modern hunter-gatherers practice open defecation by walking away from camp and just taking care of business. Over time, an unpleasant ring develops as people travel a distance that is neither too close to camp to cause problems, but neither too far away to be dangerous. As many hunter-gatherers are mobile, they move before enough fecal matter builds up to become unhealthy. It's likely that for much of time, defecation happened in a similar way. This started to change once people became sedentary. Archaeological sediments dating to approximately 8,500 years ago from one of the world's first towns, Çatalhöyük in Turkey, show that people started to put their fecal waste in specific places. Fecal molecules spike in trash piles at this site, suggesting that people either defecated in these areas or brought their waste out with the rest of the trash. This is a form of open defecation because the waste isn't managed through a sewage system. Instead, it's just left out in the open. Although a lot has changed in Çatalhöyük, open defecation is still incredibly common throughout the world. Over 500 million people, or close to 10% of the world's population, practice open defecation today. Because open defecation allows fecal waste to build up to unhealthy levels, it can have deadly consequences. Open defecation is estimated to result in the deaths of over 700,000 people each year, a majority of those children under 5. I know that times are tough right now, but when things get better, consider donating to UNICEF. In addition to being part of the coronavirus response, they have a long-term goal of eradicating open defecation. The link to donate is below. Let's work to make open defecation history.